In this illustration, we'll discuss the photoelectrons in chamber of alpha particles. We are given that when a 4000 angstrom radiation is incident on a metal surface of work function 1.9 electron volt, photoelectrons with maximum kinetic energy are emitted, which are allowed to pass through a chamber containing alpha particles. These electrons combine with alpha particles to produce helium ion in fourth excited state. We are required to find the energies of the photons lying in 2 to 4 electron volt range that are likely to be emitted during and after the combination. Here we can see in solution, if we calculate the energy of incident radiation, this given as E is equals to 12431 by the radiation wavelength is 4000. So, this 3.1 electron volt. So, these photons when fall on a metal surface having work function 1.9 electron volt, we can write down the maximum kinetic energy of ejected electrons can be given as this Ke max can be written as E minus H nu threshold or E minus work function. So, this can be given as 3.1 minus 1.9, that is equals to 1.2 electron volt. So, this is the kinetic energy of the fastest electrons, and now these electrons when combined with the alpha particles. So, here we can write now these electrons combine with the He plus 2 and produce He plus in N equals to 5 state, as we are given that these ions are in 4th excited state. So, this is the 4th excited state when N is equals to 5. So, in this case 1.2 electron volt is the kinetic energy of these electrons, and when these will drop from infinite orbit to N equals to 5, we can write down the energy released is this delta E, which should be 1.2 plus 13.6 Z square by N square, and for Z equals to 2 for helium and N equals to 5, we calculate this 1.2 plus 13.6 multiplied by 4 by 25. And numerically this 1.2 plus 2.18, that is equals to 3.38 electron volt. So, this is the energy of photon release when these electrons combine with the He plus 2 and transform to He plus in fourth state. Further also, these electrons will drop from this fourth state to lower energy levels. And here we can first calculate the energies of different orbits. Here, energies of different orbits of He plus R. Here we can calculate energies by using this relation 13.6 Z square by N square. So, for first orbit, it is minus 13.6 multiplied by 2 square, which is minus 54.4 electron volt. Energy of second orbit is minus 13.6 multiplied by 2 square by 2 square, that is minus 13.6 electron volt. Similarly, we can write E3 minus 13.6 2 square by 3 square, that is minus 6.04 electron volt. And E4, energy of fourth orbit here is minus 13.6 2 square by 4 square, which gives minus 3.4 electron volt. And for fifth energy level, from where the electrons are dropping, is minus 13.6 into 2 square divided by 5 square, that is minus 2.18 electron volt. Now, in this situation, if we just analyze, here we can see energies in range from 2 to 4 electron volt are. Here, 1 from n equals to 5 electron d excised to lower energy level, various possible combinations are there. And out of these energies, we can see there are only 2 possible combinations. One is for 5th to 3rd orbit transition and another is for 4 to 3rd orbit transition, where energies we can calculate. It is E5 minus E3, which is minus 2.18 minus or minus 6.04, that is equals to 3.86 electron volt. And this energy we can see it is minus 3.4 minus or minus 6.04, that is equals to 2.64 electron volt. Other than these two, all possible transitions are having energies beyond the range of 2 to 4 electron volt. So only these 3 possible transitions are there, for which we can say the energies are lying between 2 to 4 electrons volt, which are emitted during and after the combination. This is emitted during combination, these two are after the combination. So this and delta E, which was emitted initially, is 3.38 electron volt. This will be the possible answer for this problem.